Welcome to the Ultimate Lifespan Podcast with Buck Risby, bringing you the latest in evidence-based but often controversial approaches to natural health and wellness with less stress. Plus, healthy advances for slipping into your ideal weight while looking and feeling younger than your years. Sprinkled with surprising stories, expert interviews, and plenty of irreverence for the status quo. If you're ready to take charge of your health and finally feel in control, buckle up and enjoy this next episode of Ultimate Lifespan.
Hey folks, Buck Risby here, another episode of the Ultimate Lifespan Podcast. Welcome, I am your host. I am the Chief Health Evangelist for Ultimate Lifespan. And as I mentioned in our first podcast episode, this is my opportunity to share my journey, what I'm learning, what I'm finding, both through direct experience and learning, and also through the interaction that I have with other experts, other practitioners, other people that are movers and shakers in the natural health space. And I got to tell you, it's had a profound impact on my life. One of the things that I discovered as a result of my journey, and I'll share a little story about my life in terms of where I've come from. I have been the fat kid for most of my life. I was the kid that was chunky. I'm in my mid-50s, so it wasn't cool to be overweight or obese when you're in your early young adulthood and teens. And when I graduated from high school, I was actually obese when I graduated. And it took a lot of time, a lot of learning, a lot of frustration over probably a span of over 40 years for me to figure out what was wrong, what I was doing that didn't make sense. And one of the things that was presented to me was this notion of, well, you know, Buck, you need to be on a low-fat diet. And so, you know, I went through that period of time when I was eating a lot of low-fat snacks and things that, you know, I thought fat made you fat. And that really turned out not to be the case. And one of the things that I discovered in that journey is this thing called butter. Now, As a kid, I was actually taught to think butter was bad for you, and that it was actually better to have alternatives to butter, such as margarine and maybe low cholesterol margarine, things like that. That's why great advertising of things like I cannot believe it's not butter and other products that claim to have, I think, you know, low cholesterol, lower price, great taste, that sort of thing, tastes like the real thing. Tastes great, but not real, were very popular. And you know, I'm actually shocked to see many of these products still advertised today, you know, decades later. But what I found was that for me, what worked and wound up being a turning point in my life was incorporating healthy fats into my diet and restricting substantially unhealthy sugar equivalents and carbohydrates, things of that nature. And I'll talk more about that in another episode of Ultimate Lifespan Podcast. But this topic really is about how, and my wife posted this, so it's a great quote, life isn't life without real butter. And that is absolutely true. I remember heading up to Canada on a road trip one time, and we were in Toronto, and they had a butter festival there, and I was just amazed at all the butter sculptures, and it was just, whoo, blew my mind. But around that time, that was the time when I went up there that people were talking about butter being bad for you. And there are quotes from famous people that were saying, you know, butter is evil, and I don't want that, you know, death stick and that sort of thing. And now, I think, you know, a few years ago, there was a Time magazine front page, you know, on the cover of Time magazine, it indicated that butter, turns out we were all wrong over the last few decades, and butter isn't the, you know, evil, but butter is not the enemy. In fact, my wife wrote here in this quote, real butter is not the enemy. It's a nutrition powerhouse with many real health benefits. Well, that's great news to me. But here's some of the things that butter can do for you. First of all, for me, and that's a big deal, it reduces the risk of obesity. And one of the powerful aspects of butter is that eating a healthy fat, and when I say butter, I'm really referring to grass-fed butter from grass-fed cows. And if you're eating butter from grass-fed cows, you're going to have something that's very healthy. It's high in omega-3s. It's high in CLA. It's high in components that are good for your body. And it also is high in what's called satiety. And satiety is just a fancy word for saying it's going to make you feel full. You're going to feel satisfied. You're not going to feel like eating more food when you eat healthy fat like butter. It prevents bone loss. It fights cancer. It supports heart health, which for me, you'll hear in another episode that I talked about, you know, having something called an EBT heart scan and making sure that my cardiovascular health was up to snuff. And it turns out that it was. But eating healthy fat like real butter from grass-fed cows can be a great addition to your diet regimen, your health regimen. It fights inflammation. It helps keep your thyroid healthy. And who doesn't want a healthy thyroid, especially when you're, you know, if you're trying to have enough energy and trying to keep the pounds off, having a healthy thyroid is critical. It protects your vision. And now I'm in my mid-50s and I wear readers, but I'm always looking for an edge to keep my vision healthy. It promotes brain and nervous system health, and it protects your gut. It protects gut health. So when you think about all those things, how could you not eat butter? How could you not have this in your life, your lifestyle? So one of the things I do when I start my day, and my wife and I do this as a routine together, we connect with each other every morning after we drop the kids off at school, and we have, you probably heard of it, you know, either butter coffee or bulletproof coffee. I've actually interviewed Dave Asprey, and he sort of came up, coined the term bulletproof coffee. So I have coffee with a tablespoon of butter from grass-fed cows. Now, one of my favorite types of butter is Kerrygold butter. Maybe you've heard of it. I tend to buy it in bulk. I'm here in America, so I go to Costco and I buy Kerrygold in bulk, and sometimes it's on sale. So we stock up, and I use a tablespoon of that in my coffee. I blend it in, and I really enjoy the satiety, the energy, the taste, the smoothness of drinking my coffee with Kerrygold butter in it. But then later on in the day, I might have butter on. Well, my wife and I have breakfast later on in the morning, and I will put a big slice of butter on my sourdough bread, my homemade sourdough bread. And again, I don't feel guilty about it. I don't feel like it's clogging up my arteries, because you know what? It really is not. And there's some aspects of butter that are really very powerful for you. One of them is the fact that it contains cholesterol. Now, you might think that, wow, that's terrible, Buck. Cholesterol, that's got to be a bad thing. I'm always thinking that, you know, either I'm taking statins or my doctor tells me I need to take statins. The cholesterol in butter is a good thing. It's essential to life, and it does not increase the cholesterol levels in your blood. So I think it's a misnomer. It's a improper reporting to say that eating cholesterol, like cholesterol that's in butter, is going to increase your cholesterol. That's actually an old nutrition myth and has served no one. So what I'm going to recommend that you do, like I do every morning, is add some butter to your life and enjoy it. It's going to have so many health benefits for you. It's going to help you lose weight. It's going to give you more energy. It's going to help you fight cancer. It's going to help prevent bone loss. It's going to give you brain health. It's going to help protect your eyes. Now, again, I'm referring to butter from grass-fed cows. So whether you're using Kerrygold or some other type of grass-fed butter, incorporate that into your life. Don't feel guilty about adding that to your coffee, maybe making your own butter coffee or bulletproof coffee. Don't feel guilty about slathering that on your bread, and enjoy. And I'm going to sign off now. I just wanted to share that with you because I was reminded of this and how I've incorporated this into my life. Life isn't life without real butter. Add it to yours. This is Buck Risby with the Ultimate Lifespan Podcast. I'll see you on the next episode.
Thanks for joining us today on Ultimate Lifespan. Head on over to ultimatelifespan.com for full recaps of every show, our controversial but educational blog articles, and to take our ever-popular 30-second health assessment quiz. See you at ultimatelifespan.com.